But in terms of Ziyarat Ashura, as we know, typically within our majalis, it's recited always in the beginning of the programs, as we usually know. Do you have some thought as to why this is?
You see, with ziyara, if we would translate the literal word ziyara, it means salutations. So, or visiting. So, in your Muharram Majlis, one of the main things that you are actually there to do is for you to come closer to the Imam, correct? Now, for us to come closer, similarly with the dua, we said that we have a direct conversation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here we send our salams, we visit the Imam. And you know, in Arabic, when we say, I'm going to azur this specific person, so I'm going to visit this specific person, I'm going to attend, we want to get the visitation of the Imam. Yeah. Once we are in the majlis, if we start by getting ourselves closer to the land of Karbala, we automatically, and I don't know if you've realized this or not, but as soon as the ziyara is recited, there's a specific connection straight away, instantly,
because
you're closer. You're closer to Karbala. You're closer to the shrine, even if we're so far away. And that is, I think, the most beautiful way asan to start. So of course, after the Holy Quran is being recited, so as I think very interestingly over here. Also, it says that you associate yourself with Allah. Then it says thumma. This specific word thumma is very important. Then the infallibles. Right. That is very important.
So it's a sequence.
And a lot of the attacks that we usually get is we put Allah and the infallibles in the same category. No, this is Imam Zain al-Abidin teaching us. Mm. He's saying that I'm going to associate myself with Allah thumma, then the infallibles.
Sure.
And then this, so the Quran we start, and then we get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we get close to the infallibles through the ziyarah.
Subhanallah. That's